Talking to Jesse Vargas, April 4th, Saul Canelo Alvarez, Danny Jacobs. You know both of them.
50-50 fight, man.
50-50 fight. You're representing Mexico, of course.
Yeah, as always.
You're representing Mexico in the Olympics, of course, too.
Yes, sir. But I would have to say it's a 50-50 fight. Anything can happen. Daniel Jacobs is a very talented boxer. And Canelo is a more of a pressured fighter. He can also outbox his opponents and try and look for the counterpunch. But I see in this fight, out of the two, I see Daniel Jacobs being the better boxer. You know, fighting from the outside, fighting inside, outside, and maintaining his distance. That's the only way that he can come out with the victory in this fight. But it's not going to be easy because Canelo is a power puncher and he is very experienced. So for that reason, you know, I wouldn't put my money on either guy just because it's such a close fight.
Manny Pacquiao got a helicopter yesterday. Canelo got a Bugatti yesterday. If you could have anything in a form of transportation, what would you get next? A private jet? Would you get a Lambo? Would you get one of Lupe's cars that cost like $300 million?
I know, and you know what? I've heard that vehicles are the worst investments, so
it's
I probably
true.
Wouldn't do a vehicle.
Okay.
Man, I mean, I like properties. The bigger the house, the better
Smart
for me.
Smart guy.
Yeah.
Mikey, if he fights Lomachenko. Loma wants to fight. Mikey wants to fight. We just have to iron it out.
I like that fight. I like that fight for both. It would be a tough one, and it's a fight that...
It's a good fight for Mike.
Good
go.
Fight?
It's a good fight for Mike. Mike is a good fighter.
I want to bring Lupe in for good my fight. Next question. Good fight for Mike. Now, did you hear about this today?
What?
So, Poo left the heavyweight. True story. I don't know if you guys saw the video.
I did.
I was there in Costa Mesa.
We were just
Mesa.
Talking about it.
I'll tell you the story. This girl that I never seen in my life. I've been covering boxing for many, many years. Never seen her, so I don't know if she's really a reporter or not. I'm not going to say because I don't know her.
I've never seen her
Never seen
either,
her. And
ever.
She's from Vegas.
Never seen
okay,
her
Okay, never seen her. So after the fight, she does a little interview with Pulev, and then he kisses her. Today, she had a press conference with Gloria Allred.
Yep.
That was the last person I would want to represent me. But what do you guys think? I don't want nothing to do with Gloria Allred.
I don't like
her opinions. I don't like her look. Don't like nothing about her.
She is...
All I can tell you is somebody's getting paid.
She's going to be the next anchor of SportsCenter on ESPN or something?
You can't go around kissing somebody in the mouth without permission.
That's true, though, man. I mean, no matter what. I mean, if you had a sister, your aunt, whoever was working, and a boxer, a fighter, you just came up and kissed her in the mouth, you're not going to be happy about it. It's a little bit of disrespect. As I see it.
My only advice to him is get a good lawyer.
Call Lupe?
No, don't call me.
Not to call you, Lupe. You're like the best lawyer in the world.
Call some lawyer, but don't call me. You're going to need a lawyer.
How much do you think a settlement in this case is just to make her go away?
It's very difficult to guess, but it's...
She won't have to do naked sushi anymore? Like, she does the sushi in her events.
Let's just say he's got a problem in his hands. He should get a lawyer.
Okay, he should have not done that. Looking back.
I mean, I'm not a lawyer and I know that. You know what I mean?
So if you interviewed a female fighter and she kissed you after...
You don't need to be a lawyer to understand you can't just kiss a girl in the mouth who's doing an interview with you. Like, you're not supposed to do that.
Yeah, man.
So if I'm interviewing a female athlete and she tries to kiss me, I should just do it or not?
Call me.
Call, yeah.
After it happens.
If some girl kisses you, Allie, without your permission, you
on
call
on camera.
Me.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think, Marvin, I don't think that's
hopefully
a problem.
Hopefully she has a lot
that
of
never,
money.
That never happened.
Hopefully.
But he's supposed to fight Tyson Fury next, so we'll see how all this affects that. That's the goal, you know, to put him on.
Well, it's better it happen now than after that fight because, you know, it would be much more money then.
But we'll on the positive side, not that there's anything positive, this makes him a household name and he makes him crazy famous. Comes with a price, but at least everybody knows him now because last week he may have not had this notoriety. Like, who is Pulev?
Well, I don't know if a kiss really puts you on the boxing scene, you know what I mean? But that's the fame that you want to get. I mean, you could be right.
There's one boxer that walked out of the ring before the fight started. He got fame. You know what I mean? Like, there's different reasons to get attention.
He probably got famous, but he didn't get another fight.
fight. By the way, what's it like to train with Freddie? I mean, let's go back a step. You were in camp with Floyd for many years. You were the first fighter that Floyd signed. What did you learn from Floyd Mayweather being around him?
Work ethic. You know, his work ethic was...
No one works as hard as Mayweather?
No.
What does that mean?
I haven't seen it yet.
Everybody works hard, Jesse.
Yeah, man. I mean, I don't know. He's there's a reason why, he's TBE. You know, that's just the reason behind it.
Okay, and what do you learn from being around Freddie? Because it's your first camp with him ever, right?
You know, he's a very knowledgeable trainer.
Like what? What is, give
very
me an example.
Very knowledgeable,
something
very
learned.
Experienced. And, I mean, he explains things pretty darn good. You know, and explains why and and how it's going to work.
Message cool. to your fans where they can follow you.
Yeah, well, I want to thank everyone for the support. Follow me on Instagram, Jesse Vargas _ Jesse with the IE, and I appreciate all the support. Come to my fight April 26th, and if you cannot be there, tune in to The Zone. Subscribe now. It's for a very good price. You're going to enjoy the fights.
All right, there you have it. Lupe, Jesse Vargas, what can you expect April 26th in Los Angeles?
Oh man, it's gonna be a good fight. You know, Soto always comes to fight.
Smart, crafty guy.
Yeah, and he knows this is a major challenge, so it'll be a really good fight. My prediction is the fight is gonna be stopped before the 10th round. I think Jesse's gonna stop him, but it's gonna be a good fight in the meantime.
All right, there you have it. Jesse Vargas, Lupe, and his dad over here. Stay tuned. FuseReport.com. We're back reporting. Okay.